to the Goons Podcast.
Sharton.
Welcome back to the Goon Podcast.
Welcome back.
How is everyone doing?
Nobody wants to do this anymore. We have to do this. That's why we're here. We want to kill ourselves.
That's not true. I enjoy this.
McNasty sleeps all day and is a depressed, lonely, stupid
I enjoy
human.
The company of
I
the
wanna
Goons.
I want to die.
I like this.
Yeah, I quite enjoy this, and I don't mind it whatsoever. It's an hour out of my life, and it's not that big of a deal.
Some of my favorite times is this and Goons Gaming. I really like doing Goons Gaming.
I wouldn't mind to get... Oh, yeah, Goons Gaming, that thing we don't do anymore ever. Yeah.
Yeah, you wouldn't be able to tell that we like it by our upload schedule, but...
Do we like it?
Yeah.
I enjoy it.
I'd hope so. It was your idea.
It was my idea.
Mm-hmm. And then you abandoned it. Like a little child.
Yep.
You conceived it and left
Goons
like
Gaming's
a bad
an orphan
dad.
Now.
It is.
Being mistreated in a foster home.
You need to post that hardcore porn game, Soup.
I know. I just had to
Did
go
you
through
not
and...
post that yet?
No, because I still have to go through and edit out boobies.
Oh.
You know what? Honestly, at that point, I don't even care if that channel gets nuked, so we could just leave the boobies in.
Let's go. Well, there's like penetration in it, so
yeah, there's like
yeah, there
is.
Sex. Yeah, there actually is like
I'm scrolling through
sex.
The footage right now, and it's just, yeah.
If you have a channel that gets banned for something like that, do your other channels get banned? Like, do you get like IP banned?
Actually, you can, because I know, Keemstar isn't allowed to make videos technically.
Yeah.
He doesn't own Drama Alert. It's somebody else's.
Yeah. He's on his like fourth time of that too. He got nuked several times.
Yeah, he did. It's like a little cockroach keeps coming back.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that probably not a good idea to put full on nudity on that channel.
Dude, really? Are you serious?
Mm-hmm.
Are you for real?
Being 100%
he sounds pretty
serious.
He sounds like he's being 100 right now.
Yeah, that is one that I didn't like the way you said that.
100.
That sounded like if sour cream could speak.
A Honda.
He's being 100 right now.
you're being kind of a Toyota right now. A little bit of a Camry.
Never say that again.
Okay, I'm sorry. Is it Chevy Truck Month? Did I disrespect
sacrilege.
The culture?
Ford Truck Life.
Okay, my bad.
Wow.
I'm sorry, Soup. You excited for your show tomorrow?
I am.
So what are you guys doing for like? How do you film it? How do you go about filming a live show?
I don't know. We're hiring
with cameras
some people to do it. So
I'm no shit cameras, but like, because usually for like I don't know. I guess it depends on the style you're doing. I feel like for a lot of like live music videos, they still include like some random crowd sounds.
Well, it's not going to be like an actual music video. It's just going to be the live like performance.
Okay. Yeah. Interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah. So do they like take your audio right from like the sound dude? How does that fucking work?
I'm pretty sure it's just going to be camera audio. There's a YouTube channel called Hate56 that I think they do the camera audio, but they have like a Rode mic. So, I mean, it's not as good.
Oh, okay, that makes sense. So it's not,
yeah.
Oh, like a little shotgun mic that goes on the top of it or whatever?
Yeah, it's not as good as, you know, getting, like, soundboard audio. But
yeah.
You get the, like, crowd screaming and shit in there. And it's not like, horrific, you know? It's not going to be, like, white noise, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't think it was going to be, like, 2010 iPhone 4.
Like when people send you their, like, Snapchat of a concert and the audio is just,
Yeah, no.
Bro, I actually hate that shit. Why do people do that?
Cutting in
like,
and out.
Like, they will literally put half an hour of a concert in their Instagram story.
Like, did
Nobody
you even enjoy it?
That.
You just looking on your phone the whole time.
You know what I hate is 4th of July.
Oh, everyone sent you their fireworks?
There's like 6 million fucking fireworks. I'm like, oh my god, nobody cares.
It's like, yeah, I've seen my own.
Oh.
Yeah.
There's no firework that you have seen that I haven't seen. They're all fucking the same shit.
It's shit exploding, bro.
Unless somebody dropped like an A-bomb in your town or something, don't send
it
to me.
Cool.
That would be rad.
Nuking Japan for the 4th of July.
Like if somebody just blew up a house or something, I'd be down for that. That'd be cool.
They strapped a baby to a rocket. Like, maybe record that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, record your felonies and put them on the internet for the world to see.
If you want social credit,
do it. And then lie in court and say you didn't do it.
The coolest firework I ever seen was, I remember seeing one that was a smiley face when I was a kid.
Yeah.
That was like the coolest thing.
My brain still don't know how that works exactly.
I don't know.
How you make it explode and make smiley
face. Certain chemicals make different colors and you have to put them in a certain order, I guess.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel, yeah, I really would not even know where to start to do that. If somebody told me to make a smiley face firework, I would not know where to start.
Dude, this guy that my friend knows, he's into like pyrotechnics and shit.
Mm-hmm.
And New Year's last year, he, or it might have been 2 years ago, he like set up all this pyro shit, and they spent like $6,000 on fucking fireworks.
Damn.
And they had like music going, and it like the fireworks were exploding to the music and like going off.
Oh,
music.
Okay, that's kind of sick.
That's cool.
See, I wouldn't mind getting that Instagram story sent to me.
Yeah, that was pretty
shit.
Sick to see in person. I didn't record any of it because I was like too interested
enjoying
in
it
at the moment.
Just living in the actual moment, unheard of. Yeah,
not allowed.
I don't know how the fuck you learn how to do shit like that. That's so interesting.
Yeah, I don't. It's not like you can just go to school. Well, actually, I don't know. Is there
I think
school,
school for
firework guys?
Pyrotechnics.
Firework degree.
Firework guy degree.
I'm sure you definitely have to be like licensed to do pyrotechnics.
To shoot off explosives pretty, in the air? Nah,
pretty,
not in America.
Dangerous.
Hey, nah, people don't need it for gender reveal parties, so I don't know why a pyrotechnic guy.
Well,
would.
Maybe not for fireworks, but if you're talking about like fucking. Flames and
yeah.
shit? Yeah, probably.
Well, you should be. I don't know. I don't know the reality of it, but you absolutely should, because we got retards
it,
burning down all of California.
Isn't it, so. Isn't it legal to own a flamethrower in the U.S.?
Not a flamethrower.
So, like, a flame lobber? Like, where do they draw the line?
Flamethrowers are made with napalm. They shoot napalm that's on fire.
Okay, so...
You can buy ones where you just connect a propane tank to it. And it's just flaming, you shoot like a flame.
What is that called, then?
So it's basically like a giant lighter.
Like, not a flamethrower, is I think one that Elon Musk made,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
Oh, is it actually
it's just
called
a huge
not a
fucking lighter.
Yeah, he sold it as not a flamethrower.
Yeah, it's literally called not a flamethrower.
You know what? That's fair. He's a weird guy, but he does some fun shit.
Yeah.
I don't...
You see his haircut?
I didn't see his haircut. Maybe they can get away with it by not, like... shooting as far as an actual flamethrower?
Well, yeah, actual flamethrowers. Can't they shoot like 100 feet or something insane?
Well, flamethrowers, you're shooting a liquid at something that's like on fire.
It's not gonna get off. Yeah.
Yeah. You can probably
yeah, I guess propane
I bet
is
if you
different.
If you took that not a flamethrower and just like quick burst it at somebody, literally all it would do is probably just singe hair.
Yeah.
Like you're not gonna catch somebody on fire instantly with a
But how much modifying do you need to do to get it to that point? It's probably not very much.
No, probably, like, very, very little.
Are you asking for you or a friend? Or
I was typing it into Google.
Well, you can do that same thing with a gun by just buying a bigger clip.
What?
So you can do that same thing with a gun by just buying a bigger clip, make it illegal.
Yeah, there's a lot of ways to modify.
Oh,
If they're selling a legal product, it's whatever. It's if you're making it illegal, then it's on you.
You can put an illegal copy of Pac-Man on a flash drive and you go to prison.
Has anybody ever actually gotten in trouble for doing something like that? Like, has anyone really
actually,
ever cared?
Yeah.
The only person that, really? The only people that ever get in trouble for like pirating and stuff are the people that create the software for pirating.
Or they create the game and sell it.
I got an email once from my old internet provider. I torrented a movie on Pirate Bay and they actually sent me an email saying,
yeah,
stop
I remember
that
too. I remember I got something like that.
Damn, that's crazy. And then I didn't listen to them and they never actually did anything about it. So we're good.
Yeah, I
remember
that too.
I've yet to be sued until maybe
your
today,
day is coming,
podcast.
Blarg.
Yeah.
Just don't do it to fucking Nintendo.
Oh, they'll...
Yeah, I don't fuck with Nintendo. They will literally bomb
you.
Your house.
Japan is so bad with that stuff.
I was at a crime museum in Tennessee recently and there was a little section there of pirated games. And it was like, I should have took a picture because I was fucking dying laughing at it. There was like an Xbox 360 box, but the cover was like Mario. It was like an Xbox game. It looked so
what
fucking
crazy.
It looked like a deep fried meme.
It
and it was like,
sounds like a
pirated
deep fried meme.
Games and movies are not a joke. And I was like,
yes, they absolutely are.
Yeah, it's a good meme.
Do you guys remember the commercials that were like, would you pirate a car or something? And like,
oh,
trying
yeah.
to make it
so you
seem
wouldn't pirate
so
music.
Much more. Yeah.
Yeah.
You wouldn't fuck a dog in its ass. Yeah, those commercials were actually the stupidest fucking
dude,
thing ever. You wouldn't rail dog. Why would you torrent music?
You wouldn't split your grandma in half vertical. Don't download Travis Scott on LimeWire.
I don't think Travis Scott was on LimeWire.
Did you guys use LimeWire? That was the best.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah.
Bro,
I got a bad fucking virus on that website, on that thing. Then.
I bought albums like a good little boy.
So did I, but there was one AFI song. I can't remember what it was. I was like, probably like 10, and I wanted it because my cousin had it, and I thought it was like cool and edgy. I think it was Miss Murder. Is that an AFI song? I can't remember.
Yeah.
But I tried to find it on fucking LimeWire, and I had my mom help me, and she's like, oh, I think we got it, and we downloaded it, and it was called the right name and everything, and it was literally like 20 minutes long, the audio file, and it took literally like the whole fucking day to download, and we fucking put it on a CD, and it was just porn audio.
Let's go.
It was
really?
Of course.
Deep fried fucking porn audio.
Yeah.
Like 20 minutes of porn audio.
I like you didn't question it was 20 minutes. You're like, yeah, okay, well, that's probably okay.
Dude, I was like 10. I didn't even know. Like, you couldn't tell until after. We just put it on the CD. I think it was when we were putting it on the CD that it was, like, taking a long time, and we didn't know why. And it used like half the CD's space because, you know, it's a CD. And yeah, it was just like straight up busted ass porn audio.
And I had illegally downloaded a Disturbed song one time. But see, I was always a good boy, and I would never illegally download the songs from my iPod unless I had already got the album.
Well, yeah, that's usually where you found music back then.
I felt justified.
It's a good moral compass, you know?
Yeah.
Like, guy. I bought a gun, but then I went and broke into Walmart and stole all the guns because I already had a gun. You know what I mean?
Okay, not even closely similar.
It is. It's the same thing. It's the same concept.
No, yeah. Robbing a Walmart while you're armed with a weapon is the same as torrenting music.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, you're saying I already own a gun, so I'll go steal these other guns. It's the same thing.
You know what? I'll let you win that, dude.
Okay. Well, I downloaded a Disturbed song. And it was from some fucking website, and there was like a pause in the music before like a breakdown or something, and that you can hear a guy like cough or sneeze or something.
Oh, he's like he was recording it.
And I think he was like recording the song from speakers or something.
Yeah.
And so it took a long ass time for me to be able to hear that song without the guy like in the silent.
That's so fucking
good
funny.
Good old days.
I a long time ago, again, Pirate Bay.
Pirate Bay was the best. I love Pirate Bay. Pirate Bay was the best place to not get a virus. Like, if you were good about
it. Yeah,
they
you
had
just
like
got
verified,
some busted
they had
shit.
Verified members and shit, and like,
yeah.
It was a good way to not, yeah. It was good.
It's still around. That's never going anywhere.
I got the biggest virus on LimeWire that I just, like, I think we had to throw the computer away or something.
I mean, like, yeah, that's kind of what you did back then.
How are those sites still up?
Pirate Bay still is because it's Pirate Bay is it's lit. I forget exactly. I don't know. They loopholed themselves, but yeah, they're never going anywhere from.
They changed their
Yeah, they're an organization now.
Like whatever .com is called, they changed org and then you know.
Yeah, they used to be SE, which I think is Sweden, right? Where they had weird copyright laws or something.
I think so. Yeah,
I don't remember. And then, but anyway, I downloaded an Of Mice and Men album from the Pirate Bay. And everything was great. Music was 320. Everything was perfect. And then I put it on my phone. And unlike iTunes, where it shows the album cover, it was just a picture of some dude putting the... Like, he put the album on the floor and took a picture. And that was the album cover. It was just this guy's carpet with the album on the floor. It's so fucking funny. Everything was fine, though. He did a great job with it. He just didn't know how to take a proper picture or something.
Take a JPEG from Google.
Yeah, didn't just download one. He just decided he'd take it into his own hands. Yeah, that was funny.
Speaking of piracy, I looked up something about like piracy, stealing shit, like what we've been talking about. I looked up the thing about Nintendo because in that crime museum, I was reading about some shit that they had like caught the pirates like. Hacking shit and like posting shit online. Recently, this was published 10 hours ago.
What the fuck?
Yeah. Apparently, somebody by the name Gary Bowser, I'm guessing that's their online name.
No, it's gotta be. No way, they finally caught Bowser, bro.
they got him. They got his ass. Let's go.
Gary Bowser is a 52-year-old Canadian.
of course.
A member of a group of hackers called Team Executor, specialized in 3DS and Switch modification devices, pleads guilty to two charges brought by Nintendo that is facing potential 10 years in jail and $4.5 million in fines.
Holy shit. He must have made a ton of money off that for them to be able to, like, argue that the damages were that high.
He was arrested in the Dominican Republic in 2020 and extradited to the U.S. to face 11 felony charges.
My man is hardcore. Pirating Nintendo and on the run.
Bro, just give him the fucking death sentence at that point.
Wire fraud and conspiracy to commit money laundering.
Imagine going to like a prison with like murderers and gangbangers and stuff, having to tell them.
What'd you do? I thornted Mario.
Oh my god.
That's crazy.
Video games, why I'm here.
This article is amazing. It says, let's be real. Unless the guy happens upon an infinite block of gold coins, he's unlikely to end up paying Nintendo $14.5 million in total.
What?
What the fuck?
Oh my god.
Dude, well, he had to have made a fuck ton off of what he was doing, whatever he was doing. He was, like, selling them or something. Because, like, in order to argue damages that high, like, he has to be showing income. Unless they're just, like, trying to do that to scare people and not actually expecting to get that. I don't know, but that's fucking wild. Nintendo's always been so horse-ass.
Nintendo's shitty, dude. Like, I mean, they make great games and stuff, but their, like, business practices have always been...
They're like, super old.
Didn't they used to ban... Like, didn't they used to copyright YouTubers for playing Mario Kart or something?
Yeah, you literally could not play any Mario games on YouTube. You cannot show... You literally cannot talk about
Mario.
That's
insane.
Yeah, that, like, just recently changed, too. Like,
yeah, that's in, like, the past 4 years or something.
Yeah, I was going to say, that was, like, super recent. I think that was with the Switch, was it not?
Yeah. I remember posting a Breath of the Wild video and it got claimed. So it was after that. It was maybe two years ago.
Imagine being so dumb as a company that...
No free promo.
That thinking that is a promotion.
Exactly. Yep.
They probably just didn't understand. Like, that just had to be it.
No, they absolutely didn't. Yeah, they didn't. But, like, there's no reason to not understand. No shot. Everybody that works there is a fucking pensioner. Somebody should have been like, hey, guys, YouTube is a tool we can use.
Yeah.
Like, I don't understand that. Why would nobody at the company think earlier that, like, that was a bad idea?
Yeah, I don't know.
So stupid.
Like, I can see protecting your property and your creation.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
But there's a certain area where you had to give.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, that's like, that would be like us going out of our way to, like, copyright every single TikTok that of our stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's literally free promotion. It's not hurting us. It's
sometimes
not taking away from our videos. Yeah, and it depends exactly.
Unless
the
they
comments,
decide
but,
to not give credit whatsoever and put it on a GTA race or something.
Yeah,
but,
yeah, okay. That's, I mean, like, just people that straight
those
up,
are dumb.
Yeah, those are fucking boo-boo ass, but
yeah,
you get what I mean.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah,
no,
that's like us going out of our way to copyright literally nothing. Like, there's no point.
Yeah,
I don't if anything, why, it's just free promo.
Why don't these companies, like, cut a deal with these people making, like, these modded games or pirated shit? Like, obviously, whatever this Gary Bowser fucker was doing was making a shit ton of money. Why not just, like, figure out a way to work with him? Because if he's making something that's making $14 million, like, damn, people must be fucking interested in it. Why not work with him to figure out what it is?
I think the problem is they kind of get a little butthurt when half the time what they're doing is better than what they are making. So they're like, nah, this guy's getting sued into oblivion.
Yeah, but, like, why not, like, be like, listen, man, we don't appreciate you doing this without our permission. Why don't we do it together and we go legal and you get, like, 30% or, like, you know, like, figure out some kind of way to make it work.
I do not have the answer to that one.
Like, the fucking, like, CIA or something, right? They hire hackers and shit that are shitty.
Yeah.
That are really good at their job.
There are companies that hire, like, there are gaming companies that have hired people that have, like, hacked and modded their game.
Yeah.
They mostly hire him just to, like, for, like, anti-cheat purposes.
I know Bethesda Game Studios does that a lot. Like, if they see somebody who's, like, a huge modder in the community, they will actually hire them to, like, work on assets and make, like, professionally done mods and DLCs and shit through their Creation Club shit. I don't know if it still works the way it used to, but, yeah, they did do that at a point where, like, even people just making, not even hacking, just, like, making stuff for their game, they would they would employ.
Yeah.
Smart.
And I heard they paid very well, so I don't know.
God damn, Nintendo, there's a fucking other one.
Like Superman with a huge cock.
What did Nintendo do now?
Nintendo of America has been awarded $2.1 million in damages after winning a lawsuit against pirated game seller ROM Universe.
Yeah, see, ROM sellers make sense. If you're selling something that isn't yours, then that to me is fair. I don't know what Mr. Bowser was doing, but if he was just, like, making shit, I don't know.
He was selling Nintendo Switch hacks.
Mm. See, I don't... Why? Like, what is that... How is that even hurting their business?
Apparently, it was a mod chip or a jailbroken Nintendo Switch.
That's
or something.
That's crazy. I have a jailbroken Nintendo Switch.
A USB device that allows...
Well, is he buying... So he's paying for the Switch, modding it, and then selling it.
Yeah, if anything, that's going to make people buy the Switch.
Yeah.
Well, like, yeah, if he makes them buy him so he can mod it, like... I don't understand.
So that's what's weird to me is, like, if you're buying and it's your property, you can do whatever the fuck you want to, and you can sell it. It's not illegal to sell your own property.
Well, they're selling USB sticks that have some kind of software to run pirated games on it.
Oh, they're not selling the actual Switch. Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's fair.
That's fair.
Fucking Soulja Boy did that shit.
Oh, no, he was selling...
How'd that go for Soulja Boy?
Oh, yeah.
He was straight ripping.
Apparently, he made so much money off that shit, and, like... Nobody actually came for his ass. Like, they all did, but nothing, to my knowledge, has happened to him from that. He literally just did a quick get-rich scheme, and it actually fucking worked out.
Actually worked, yeah.
That's fucking wild.
What a giga chat.
That was a weird time.
That was. I remember seeing that shit everywhere,
Soulja
like
Boy
on
was just, like, really popular again for a minute,
uh-huh.
Doing Soulja Boy shit, and then is now back to irrelevancy.
Now he just streams RuneScape.
Does he stream RuneScape?
Yeah.
Bro, hit him up. See if he wants to play RuneScape with you. Get him in a Goons video. Get him on the podcast.
I'm so down. Okay.
That's good.
We'll get him in the Discord. We'll get him in here.
He said, I would like that, but he says the N-word way too much. I don't think that would be very good. Like, every other sentence is
wait, who? N-word. I was looking up Nintendo lawsuits.
You!
Alright.
Yeah, that clip of him when somebody told him to turn down his music.
Oh, that's my favorite clip.
Might actually be one of my favorite clips on Twitch. If you're watching this and you have not seen that yet, just look up Soulja Boy Volume Too Loud. Just go do yourself a favor.
That man's goofy as hell. He don't know how to stream. Dude, and it's really funny.
I ain't your fucking daddy. Just peace boosting. Fucking, yeah.
Have you guys ever rated him on Twitch?
No.
No.
I rated him one time, and I got all the viewers to like spam, play Crank That, and he was like playing Fortnite without his webcam on or something, and he.
I think I was
fucking,
with you when you did that. I think we were streaming together.
Might have been.
Yeah, I think we both did that, I'm pretty sure.
He turned the fucking song on, dude, and it was, like, clipping. It was so loud.
Yeah,
and then he turned his webcam on and started dancing and shit, but it was so fucking loud.
It's so
funny to me that, like, people that work in music, like, that are big and then end up, like, Twitch streaming, it's like they give no shits about their audio. You'd think that they would be the people that would want to have, like, good audio.
T-Pain's audio is fantastic.
Yeah, well, he's an exception. Yeah, he actually really cares about...
Yeah, his streams are actually, like, genuinely good. Like, he's an enjoyable person to watch.
He gets good views, yeah.
Yeah, he does.
There are some people that start streaming, and they're just, like, so out of the loop, and they don't fucking know anything, and they're just... Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, obviously, they haven't had... Like, the first time we streamed, I'm sure it all looked like dog shit on our end. I mean, I guess the difference is we didn't have, like, $1 million to go pay somebody to like, help
start.
Us out.
Yeah.
Yeah, to, like, make sure our audio didn't sound like two donkeys having sex buying Applebee's or some shit. Yeah.
To come up, fair. Baby, to come up.
When, Ronnie Radke streams and he, like,
Yuck.
He, he just randomly streams Warzone and he's, like, doesn't hardly talk and he just tries to, like, be good. But when he does his streams, he'll do streams where he'll, like, react to people, like, reacting to his new songs or whatever. And he always has like 2,000 viewers in those. And then he starts playing Warzone where he's actually like trying to be good at Warzone and he's not. And then it dips down to like 300 because nobody wants to watch that shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, how do you not follow the numbers? Like,
probably doesn't give a shit.
Yeah, he just doesn't care.
Guess, yeah.
It's not like he's like, oh no, my income. It's like,
right.
Following the verse is doing fine.
I think he's
fine.
Doing okay.
Yeah.
This is just for fun.
I don't think he worries about it.
He streams pretty often though. Like, at least every couple of days.
And has a time in his busy schedule of throwing mic stands and peeing on a woman.
And killing a man.
He killed someone?
Yeah.
Really?
He did.
No way.
Wasn't that him? Didn't he kill somebody and spend time in prison? That was his thing.
Can you fact check this?
No, I think he... I don't know, actually.
Was the prison for not, like, hitting a fan in the fucking face with a...
Okay, hold on.
20-pound mic stand?
I don't know. I'm not gonna have an input on this, because I don't know.
Yeah, either. That's what I'm saying. I don't, like... I know that one's true. I know the mic stand one is true. There's videos of that one. That one's fucking hilarious. I don't know what was going through his brain, but he's getting into it. He's just enjoying the tunes, and he just says, you know what? Fuck this crowd. I'm gonna wail a mic stand full force into them. Like, those things are heavy as hell, bro. They are not light.
Have you ever watched any videos about G.G. Allen?
No.
Nope.
Dude, he was fucked.
I don't even know who that is.
Let me see if there's like a compilation. He's like an old... what fucking band was he in? I can't remember. I'm drawing a blank right now. I just remember his name.
Yeah, I that name does not sound familiar to me.
What was the band? G.G. Allen. What fucking... God damn it. What was the band he was in? Anyway... He was like a punk rock dude, like a front man, and he would like fucking fight people in the crowd. If you've never seen any of his shit, I would recommend watching some of his like compilations or whatever. But dude,
I love watching those.
He would like fight people in the crowd and like he would throw his own shit on people and stuff. Like,
what the fuck?
And he would like beat his head with a microphone and bleed on people and shit. Like, he did not give a fuck, dude. He was like,
that's insane.
He was insane.
So
Jesus.
So he didn't kill someone himself, but he met up with some friends in a fight, and one of his friends killed somebody. So he was an accessory.
Okay.
So
why did his friend kill somebody? Does it like what's the story? What's the lore?
They met at a high school to fight at 2:30 p.m. They brought additional men. Why were they fighting in the first place? This article doesn't even state why.
Turf war over that high school. G.G. Allen best fights.
I linked the video, but yeah, dude.
The fact that he has so many of them, they could pick out some of the best.
Dude, yeah, like he would literally fight like fans.
Why is
just
he,
like
is he wearing nothing but underwear?
Yeah, that's I'm telling tight. You, dude. He would like throw his own shit. He would like be bleeding and stuff. Just like
what? That is a man. That is a man's man.
That is punk rock as fuck.
He just like rushed this guy like he was a bull.
Oh, dude, he's butt naked in one of these.
Yeah, yeah, I see that from the thumbnail. He's literally wearing nothing but like a little cheetah thong. What the fuck? Have you guys ever seen a musician like fuck up and like hurt themselves on stage or something?
Oh,
or,
yeah,
like
that's
bleed
the
best. Or some shit.
Can't wait till that happens to me.
Oh yeah, you're gonna eat shit. You're gonna fall off through stage. Fuck, who was I watching? Oh my god. I can think of a song by them, but not their fucking name. Song Seven Hills. Who the fuck are they? Yeah, While She Sleeps. That's who it was. I was watching While She Sleeps play. God, I can't remember what year it was. It was at a Warped Tour in Detroit. And the guitarist jumped on his amp and went to go do like a little jump. And he smashed his head off the top bar of the stage.
Oh.
And... ate shit, fell right on the ground, got up though, maybe missed, you know, like 5 seconds of the song, got back up and just started going at it again, and his face was like bleeding everywhere.
Dude,
it
Dave
was
Grohl
fucking
fell
intense
off, fell off a stage at one of his shows and broke his leg and then continued the set. I'm pretty sure.
What, they just put him in a little wheelchair?
I think I remember that. Yeah,
yeah, they had him out in a wheelchair and they had like a nurse or something come and patch his leg up and everything.
That's
hardcore.
That's pretty badass. Yeah, that's pretty wild. I mean, at that point, it's like, if you can still sing, then like your leg's not
going
to get
any more
broken.
You have to keep
going, dude.
You can't be a bitch. You got to keep going.
Okay. I don't know if you become like paraplegic from the neck down. You have to keep going.
I mean,
you
if you're like
stop.
To the if you're foaming out of the mouth, yeah, maybe quit. But like if you got to keep going, dude.
Mm.
Yeah, no, I guess do what you can. Yeah. make do.
Make do.
With,
that's a duper dude.
Yes.
You should die.
That's something about that sentence sounded. That's what Duber did. It's got a good flow to it.
That's what Duber did.
That's what Duber did.
It's like a motto for like a brand. That's what Duber did. Thanks.
Anyway. Stop. Hey.
You guys have any plans for Christmas?
No vocal fry in the kitchen.
What now?
Do I have who?
Christmas plans.
I'm gonna kill Santa.
That's probably a good plan.
Yeah, I'm gonna set a bear trap at the at my fireplace.
Anthrax on the cookies and the milk.
Anthrax.
The whole band.
The whole band's in the cookies.
I wonder if we have any Santa denier fans.
Fuck them.
Santa denier fans.
Fans that deny the existence of Santa.
If you don't think Santa is real, then you're a pussy bitch and fuck you.
Yeah, exactly. This man only spits facts.
Only spit dip pussy.
That too.
Dip pussy?
Dip and facts.
Dip pussy.
Let's spit dip onto a fax machine.
That sounds pretty fucking nasty, to be honest.
Yeah, that sounds...
Yeah, I'll be hanging out with my family.
I don't care.
Do you guys do like a big like Christmas dinner?
We do a very small Christmas dinner. Microscopic,
like
actually.
Half of a double cheeseburger? McDonald's?
Yeah.
Everybody gets 1/4 of a Kraft single.
I fucking did.
A singed dog hair.
Everyone go pick your own leaf off the tree. You'll get a squirt of ranch on it.
That sounds pretty good, actually.
A ranchy leaf. That's just a salad.
We eat one sneeze for Christmas.
How would you go about doing that?
You just have somebody sneeze in your mouth. And
That'd be like one of those candies, like the sour spray candies where you spray it in your mouth, you know? It's all sour tasting. Yeah.
But it just tastes like fucking somebody
like
else's spit.
Snot and hemoglobin.
Hemoglobin! Okay.
Alright.
What was I going to say? I was going to ask you guys.
Lord knows. Okay. Well, only the Lord knows what you were going to say. Literally only.
I actually had a good question.
Yeah.
Alright.
I don't remember it right now.
Oh, okay, well then what good is it?
Not very good.
It was before the Christmas, well it was during the Christmas thing.
Okay, Christmas, Hanukkah. Remember.
Yeah. We're killing Santa, Santa deniers.
I think it was something to do with the anthrax.
Oh yeah, killing Santa with poison?
No. Yeah.
I don't know. I'm also playing a video game in the background, if we're being honest, so that probably didn't
help. Wow, dude, you're toxic.
Yeah, that's really wrong of you to do.
Dude, I can hear you clicking. Shut the fuck up. I can literally hear you clicking away.
I'm also playing RuneScape right now.
I'm playing with my pecker.
I'm surprised you're not playing... What? How can we stop playing Tetris? I remember we used to play that all the time.
Because everyone bullied me about it, so I quit.
You were bad.
Oh, really? Oh. You were bad, though.
Yeah, you were really fucking bad.
you're
bad.
Dude, you have no room to talk that? About people being bad at video games.
Why don't
up.
You tell the viewers about the Nazi party?
What?
They were a terrible people, and you shouldn't support them.
Oh, no, I thought I was talking about the one that you went to last weekend that you were telling us all about.
Oh, and I went up there and killed them all because Nazis are bad?
You killed people?
Yeah.
You're a murderer?
Oh, yeah.
Glad you said it.
What is happening?
The dude is a murderer.
I murder the right people.
That's fine. You know what? I would argue that is right. Good job. You're a hero, dude.
Die.
An absolute hero.
He holds no allegiance to a flag, no religion, no race.
I'm ambivalent to all things. Well, yes, creed, but everything else, no.
Creed?
Creed flag. I want a creed flag.
I'm sure they exist.
But it's just like an upscaled picture of like a 240p version of Scott Stapp's head.
Oh.
Scotch tape. Scott Stapp.
What's the difference? You tell me.
Do you think the people that work for Scott Stapp is just Scott's staff?
Man, this podcast is really only half over, huh?
Why did you hoof? Why did you aggressively
I felt the need to hoof, boy. Don't question it.
Just gotta let out a good hoof.
You guys been listening to any good music?
Nope.
I actually haven't. The only recent album that I've been listening to that has like come out recently. Gee, I just had a stroke.
When did it come out?
Is the Plot and You put out a new album, and it's actually very good. Landon Tours. I don't know if you guys know of him, but he is like probably one of the best all around vocalists and like writing his solo music.
The Plop and Poo.
Yeah, the Plop and Poo. The Plop and Toilet. Very good band.
The Plot in You, okay.
I have not heard of
them.
Yeah,
they're really tight. Their old music used to be super heavy, and now they're just kind of write whatever the fuck, but even Landon Tour's like solo music is very good.
I just listen to old Toby Keith songs and drink beer.
You,
That's sad.
You yeah. are seriously having an identity crisis. Stop trying to be me, McNasty.
Only Soup listens to country, by the way.
Only man that has ever done it.
I'm the only one that listens to country and drinks beers at the same time.
That's right.
You're not allowed to do both at the same time. That's okay, my trademark. Right.
It's like when any human ever plays guitar and it's like, oh, you're trying to be the dude. It's like, yeah, I
exactly.
am.
Exactly. No one else is allowed to play guitar.
I am the first guitar player, the first and last. That's correct.
That's why I switched to bass.
Good. That was the right decision.
I listen to Falling in Reverse and drink Monster. There.
There we go. That's
that
nice.
Sounds like
God, that sounds like a 14-year-old's wet dream.
You wouldn't know a lot about those, wouldn't you, Blar?
I'm not the one that likes Minecraft, might I remind you.
Okay, true. I've been listening to this band called All Hail the Yeti.
What okay. genre is Yeti? That? Like the Yeti mugs?
Of course.
Yeah. They're pretty good.
Just a bunch of guys praying to a Yeti cooler.
When you think about it that way, it kind of sounds like a country band.
All Hail the Yeti.
Yeah. All Hail the Yeti. Yeah. Oh, so many silver bullets. God damn.
Dude, Yeti are actually, it's a good fucking product. You guys own any Yeti stuff?
Yeah. Yetis, Hydro Flasks, got them all. I collect them.
I have a cooler, and man, you can put ice in that thing and check it a week later, and there'll still be fucking ice there.
Yep.
That shit keeps ice cold for so long.
Yep.
Yeah, my roommate spilled hummus in mine, so it stunk.
Ugh.
How do you spill hummus in a...
I know, it's such a thick thing.
Like, wait, you mean like a... How do you spill hummus, first of all?
We took it camping, and we had hummus, and he dumped it in my fucking Yeti, and it was stinky.
Uh-oh. That's not really spilling, that's intentionally...
Dumping
taking it out of the...
Well, no, it was an accident, at least what he told me, but he might be an imposter.
You know, if I slid open a baby's stomach and its entrails fell out, I wasn't spilling the entrails.
What?
It was intentionally.
What the fuck?
Sorry, I've been listening to a lot of death metal lately. A
lot of Cannibal Corpse.
A lot of grindcore.
Porcupine Tree is a good band that I've been listening to.
Porcupine Tree?
You're just making shit up now.
It sounds like a town in like fucking Animal Crossing or something.
Dude, listen to Porcupine Tree. They're great.
Is it like Joshua Tree?
Yeah, I don't want to listen to your propaganda.
Okay.
Your porcupine propaganda.
Okay. You guys think I'm making up band names now?
Yeah.
I listen to Meat Slab Guys.
I listen to Upside Down Fridge daily. The freezer's on the bottom. It's weird.
Greta Van Jeff.
Oh, I actually really like Greta Van Fleet. They're
their front man's on drugs or something. He's a weird guy.
I don't care. I don't give a damn.
Okay.
I'm
not saying that you should.
I mean, the whole 80s, everybody's fucking high.
Dude,
well,
shut the fuck up, dude. Half the rock bands that we fucking grew up listening to were doing drugs.
No, you know, it's fine. I support drugs. Do drugs. Like, literally everyone watching, do drugs.
Speaking of drugs, G-Sups, dude.
Yeah!
We are paid to promote drug use on this podcast.
That's right. Use code GOONS for your drugs.
Are we going to get age restricted?
We're selling drugs through this podcast. Listen, IRS.
YouTube is listening to this shit for 40 minutes.
Ain't nobody listening to this bullshit.
We actually have a lot of people listening to this bullshit for whatever fucking reason.
Wait, people are listening to us?
The people that review this channel probably listen to it for 30 seconds. They're like, okay, they didn't say fuck, so just let it go.
Whole lot of slurs, but no fuck. We're good.
Alrighty then.
That's true, actually.
That,
I thought about that.
I didn't
that.
Consider that until right now.
That's another band I've been listening to.
Okay, see, you know what? Now I'm starting to believe you are making them up.
We should make a band called Wallop.
We should make a band called Code Goons.
Mm-hmm. I'd probably sell a lot of money.
Sell a lot of money.
Sell a lot of
money.
Dude.
Is that allowed?
The bank.
I think you just fixed the stock market.
Just sell your money.
I just took the U.S. out of debt in one sentence.
Damn.
Just sell the money.
Isn't the concept of currency kind of wild?
It is weird.
It really is that your quality
it's
of life.
Because back in the day, currency was just like doing a favor for somebody or, you know, trading
like
stone
shekel.
You know,
yeah, you do this thing for me,
I'll
give
them
you a cow or something.
For carrots.
Yeah,
my ancestors didn't call it favors.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. What did they call it, Soup?
I don't know what they called it, but it probably wasn't good.
Probably?
No, I feel like most things your ancestors did were probably not good.
I don't know, dude. Moonshine ain't too bad.
I had nothing to rebuttal this, but I don't know, dude.
Moonshine isn't too bad. Come on now.
I mean, we didn't really have to do that much work.
I can forgive the years of slavery for moonshine.
Have you ever actually had like legit moonshine before?
Yeah.
Isn't it like blind you? Can it blind you? Isn't that a thing?
It can blind you. Drink too much of it. Yeah.
Really?
Is it because like kill you before it would blind you? Wouldn't
it? Is it because it's made in like a bathtub with like copper or some shit? Like what? What is the lore?
No, I mean they distill it like they have to find like a good water source. So they do it like out in the woods somewhere where there's like a good like creek or something. I don't know.
Yeah, like natural water source.
Yeah, but I've had like some cinnamon tasting moonshine shit that this random dude gave me.
If you tell me it's a Sam's Club parking lot, I'm actually gonna.
It was not. It was not in a Sam's Club parking lot.
I'm gonna lose my fucking mind.
Your Sam's Clubs are the shadiest places on the planet, dude.
Places just like international waters in South Carolina. You can do whatever the fuck you want.
You can buy goat organs and monkeys and.
I didn't buy a fucking monkey, by the way.
He did buy a monkey. It was in the title of the podcast, therefore.
Yeah, you'd be a lot cooler if you did have a monkey. I'll tell you that.
Yeah, I wish I could.
Imagine having a little monkey on your shoulder like during your streams.
That would be sick.
That's literally what I said. I would love to have it for that particular reason.
Yeah, but wouldn't it be cool if you had it on your shoulder during streams?
Have you thought about also having it on your shoulder in recordings? And he replies with an occasional oog.
Yeah,
dude, I would literally use him for content and then hand him to someone else to be taken care of.
What if you were like streaming though, and you just saw his tail go up on the side of you, and then he just blasted diarrhea all over your face, just boom,
dude,
out of stream.
Dude, I was fishing the other day, and this bird landed on like this fucking tree that was like hanging out of the water, and I was just looking at this bird, and he fucking bent over and shot shit out of his ass like projectile, just into the lake, and I was like, that was fucking wicked.
You're such a 14-year-old boy.
This is the most man conversation.
Let's drink a beer to that.
Didn't wipe or nothing. He bent over, shit, and
dude,
just fucking flew away.
What the hell are they wiping?
And I'm like, that is how I want to live
my life.
He just
used the lake as a toilet, pretty much.
It was like the most inspirational thing I had seen.
Yeah. Free the diarrhea. That's what I'm saying.
The world is your shit canvas.
Right.
The world is your toilet. Yeah.
Speaking of bird shit, Danielle and I were at this Christmas market in Toronto, and there was this little kid there, and it snowed hard, and he was ill prepared, but he had this jacket like over him to like try to stop the snow from landing on him, getting him more wet, so he couldn't see, and he fucking tripped and ate shit on the ground, and I felt really bad. I was like, man, this guy's got to be having a bad day. And then when he was on the ground, I looked, and there was so much bird diarrhea down his back that he probably didn't even know about. So his bad day was like, fuck, I'm soaking wet, and I just fell. He's going to get home after having a bad day at the market and just find bird slop on his back. There was so much. It literally it looked like somebody hit his back with like a wet paintbrush. It was all white, too. It was so gross.
Damn.
He's like fucking 12 too, so he's just gonna go listen to Juice WRLD and cry the rest of his night.
I told y'all about my cousin that was trying to get me to like lick bird shit off of a fence one time, didn't I?
Yeah.
I don't know. Did you?
Didn't you think you were retarded
or
something?
I feel like all your family stories blend together.
It was No, they weren't retarded. We were like 10.
No,
I thought
you were retarded.
How could he ever get that idea?
What was that math?
Huh?
I thought that he thought that you were retarded.
He thought you were retarded, but
you
thought
he
was.
He thought
that
I thought
you thought he was retarded.
I literally said two
thoughts. I
thought
peacock.
Anyway.
Isn't that a Young Gravy song?
It was a girl. And we were like, I don't know if we were 10. We were probably younger than that. But we were out by like a chain link fence, and there was bird shit all over the top of this fence. And she was licking the shit off of the fence and was like, it tastes like s'mores.
Was she retarded?
She's definitely retarded.
And she was like, it tastes like s'mores. Try it. And I'm like,
no, it doesn't.
Fucking
not.
No. And I was younger than her, too. She was like my, like,
she was guardian. Like 27.
That's your guardian?
Yeah.
She found her kink.
This was like 2 days ago.
Okay.
No, but she was licking the shit off the fence and was like, it tastes like s'mores. You got to try it. And I'm like, what the fuck? You're older than me. You should know not to eat bird shit. Like,
yeah, I feel like that's a given. Like, just like, not eat bird shit.
That's something you learn pretty early on, not to eat shit.
And that is a true story, too. That is, I did not make that one up.
I don't know. That's, you've been making up a lot of stuff this podcast.
I want to do your makeup.
Sure.
I mean, you wear a dress already.
Twice.
Imagine that's your fucking comeback. Don't you wear dresses?
Oh, only twice. Fuck off. It was two times.
Yeah, but he made a bunch of money from it, so.
How many times did you jerk off in the dress, though, is what I want to know.
Be honest.
I would have to. If I did that, I would just have to.
I would have to.
You know what? Maybe I'll find something here. I'm going to give it a go.
Why do you have to?
I don't know. Just because. Like, when are you ever going to wear a skirt, you know?
Whenever you want. You're a fucking free, grown man
whenever
individual.
Whenever you want. It's 2021. You can wear whatever you want.
I don't have an interest in wearing skirts.
Well, I don't.
But I'm saying if I was put in a position where I was already wearing a skirt, I have to just whip it out and just test it. You know, maybe
what,
you find something
what
freaky.
How would you get into that position where you're just wearing a skirt?
I make videos on Omegle on guitar on YouTube.
I don't just... I'm like, I'm not wearing one right now. I did it for the memes.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Fucking prove it.
Well...
Do it. What is everybody wearing right now? What is everybody wearing right now, the goons?
A goons...
Sweats and a t-shirt.
Goons t-shirt and some Lululemon shorts.
I actually ripped all my skin off, so... Oh.
Okay, do you have clothes over top of your bones?
No, or? Muscles are hanging out. I'm dying.
Mm-hmm. That's pretty metal. I'm just wearing a champion shirt and sweats.
I duct taped a monitor to me.
Do you need
what
help?
About you, dude? Twitch shirt?
Sweats and a t-shirt.
Twitch shirt and shirts. Oh, sweats.
What kind of sweats?
Gray sweats so you can see my cock.
Let's go, baby.
Post
do
it.
Do cocked up.
Post it.
Let's
lap
go.
Pick. Lap pick.
Oh, you want to see it? I'll post it.
Of course you will.
I'm pretty sure both my editors have cock blackmail on me. The amount of times I've stood up to, like, do something while recording, wearing gray sweatpants, and, like, you're at home, so, you know, you just don't need underwear ever.
Just balling out.
I'm not wearing underwear right now, actually.
No reason. What are you
doing? I'm not wearing anything. I ripped all my skin off.
Yeah, I remember that. Way to circle back on that.
Yeah,
Circle jerk a dog.
What are you actually wearing, though, Sue? We all answered normally. Just, like, skin's not on.
I'm wearing a dog corpse over my body.
Oh my
okay,
god.
Now that's the actual answer.
Okay. Okay.
Damn, can dude, you're packing.
Can you please tweet that?
I don't know.
Oh my god, dude.
No, you know what? I'm going to tweet it.
It kind of looks real though. Like
wait, what real? Do you mean? What do you mean? That is
the
real.
Size of an apple.
That is real.
Like if we
Israel.
If we knew that you were black, then yeah, I totally believe it.
I'm white.
If you know what, if Grizzy sent me that picture, I would believe it.
Yeah.
Well, you know what they say about scrawny white dudes.
That is true.
They're scrawny and white. Wait,
they got big schlong.
You're worthless and ugly. I'm tweeting that picture, and I'm saying stop sending me this shit at the dude.
Okay, at me in it.
Dude's like, fine, like a girlfriend, she's like, I have a big old cock.
Are you actually gonna let him do that?
Are you wearing Uggs? What the fuck are you wearing?
What do you mean those are socks?
Why are they oversized?
What do you mean?
What are you talking about?
That's just a lighting, Soup.
Where do you even see my feet
oh,
at?
Oh, that's the lighting. It looks like you're wearing Uggs.
He's got knee-high socks on.
Those are my sweatpants.
It looks like you're wearing Uggs, bro.
I was like, what the fuck are you talking about? It just sweats the whole way.
Yeah.
Are you really going to post that?
He did.
I already did.
Oh, my God.
Liked and retweeted.
How is that breaching his privacy?
I don't know. If he walks around in public like that, people are going to be like, oh, my God, it's Duschlong.
Oh, my God, I've seen that cock somewhere.
I've seen those gray sweatpants.
With that cock specifically in them.
It's just always hard, too, for some reason.
Yeah.
No, that's flaccid, boys.
Yeah. Okay.
That's flaccid?
Bro, you need a meat hook to hold that thing up.
Yeah, I walk around with a sling around my neck for my dog.
That's gonna get taken out of context. Have you guys seen that?
That should be we should put that as the thumbnail.
Dude's cock.
Do penis with a red arrow going into the head.
Use actual
cock. Do cock. There's a Twitter that just takes everything, like all of our videos, podcasts, everything, and just like posts shit out of context. And there's so many of Dude talking about his cock. It is actually insane how many times we talk about Dude's penis.
Yeah, stop sexualizing me.
It's just a...
You just sent us a fucking slong pic.
You just... Not even... That's like a hog.
Stop gaslighting us.
Well, that's a whole ass thanger right there. That's a boy. That's a man. That thing's got to pay rent. You cannot just say a little pecker shot. That thing has a mortgage and kids. It's got to look like a little TikTok woman.
You got to get that thing's ears pierced.
Okay.
I got a ball piercing each for one
isn't
testicle.
Isn't that a Prince Charles piercing? Tip of your dick? Is that what it's called?
Oh!
Prince Charles?
Ooh. Yeah. I feel like it's Prince Charles. I don't know. Somebody Google Prince Charles.
No.
And not the guy.
Isn't just Prince Charles going to show up?
Google Prince Charles, but not the guy. All right.
Dude, just do piercing. You fucker.
I just did, but not the guy.
Isn't Prince Charles also it's like a tobacco or something?
Is Prince Charles gay is the first thing that comes up. That's wonderful.
Highly likely.
Oh! Is Charles the one that was like 200 that was in the back of the Range Rover picture?
No, that was,
Inbred number six. I don't know. I don't know anything.
It might have been.
This.
I'm not sure. Yeah.
Fuckers.
I looked up Prince Charles penis and I'm not seeing it.
You are in the wrong.
Prince
what is
Albert.
That? Albert. Prince that's
Albert.
What it is.
Prince Albert. Yeah, that's the tobacco. You can use it to stuff into tobacco pipes.
Prince Albert penis. Oh! No.
Yeah, you found it. Yeah, you found it. All right.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Holy
right
shit.
Right through the cock hole, right?
Yeah, I knew a guy that had that, and he was very open about showing it, and it's just medically fascinating. Like, it's the only time where I've been like, oh my god, like, I actually want to keep observing this penis.
Does he have to sit down to pee?
Does what he take it out to pee?
No. You can pee fine. I think it does a little double stream, like, if you don't pee after nutting right away. Like a little snake bite.
But then your cock, your ring is just full of piss all the time.
Yeah, like, how does your ring, does it not get infected?
Say, yeah, like, that's a good thing.
It's not, but, like, there's more, you're gonna cum on it, bro. Like, that, it's gonna
does
get
it
a lot
get
worse.
Does it not get infected or cause blockage or anything? Like,
I really don't know. We can get him, you know what, we can get him on the podcast and ask him about his little wiener.
Man, I'd actually be down. I'm curious.
Yeah, like, I've actually not talked to that guy in, like, 10 years, probably.
Just
so.
Text him and be like, yo, dude, we're talking about your penis.
Bold of you to assume I kept the number of the guy with the wiener piercing.
Why wouldn't you?
I don't, you're the one bringing him up, Blarg. I don't know. You might be sending butthole pics back with him. I don't fucking know, dude.
Send him my little taint piercing I have.
Save him in your phone as Prince Albert.
My little taint piercing. My little taint piercing.
What's that song from? What's that sound so familiar?
My Little Pony.
That? Oh, no, you're going to attract the 40-year-old guys.
The bronies. Yeah.
That is got to be the worst community in the world, right?
Oh, I know, dude. There's no way that every single My Little Brony isn't a pedophile. Like, you just...
No, they all are. It's absolutely...
There's no way you can be, like, sexually into something like that and
little
not...
Little horse thing.
You know, I was talking about before the podcast with my roommate about how Coppercad used to be, like, peak internet weirdom. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you guys remember Coppercad?
No.
No.
The gingers have souls.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, that was considered weird. And now
that was
look
like
at
the weirdest
shit that
guy.
We have. Yeah.
Well, to be fair, bronies have been around for a long time.
Yeah, they have.
Yeah, but I just mean, like, in comparison, like, South Park made fun of Coppercad. Uh-huh. But now look at the fucking shit that we have now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like he looks normal almost in comparison.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he does. Yeah, like the dude that was the fat dude with the lightsaber. Like, that was the craziest shit on the internet at that point.
Yeah, didn't they do a whole episode? They did a whole episode where it was like all the most famous, like, weird, like, Chocolate Rain guy and
oh, really?
Lightsaber guy. Yeah, South Park did that.
Chocolate Rain guy, that stream of him not knowing his mic is repeating.
Oh,
you guys have seen that, right?
Yeah.
I know I've showed you guys that, right?
Yes, you did show us
that. Dude, it's so fucking good. These mics repeating the whole time. Doesn't know. Does like a whole TF2 match, and it is just hell on earth by like 10 minutes in. So literally just noises in this super deep bassy tone. Yeah, that's what a weird guy. Does he still stream or anything? Like, is that guy still making content?
Chocolate rain.
He used to stream wearing a full like 3-piece suit, so that gave me weird vibes.
Oh. Yeah, he always came off as kind of like gooberish.
Yeah. Now, what do you mean by goober?
He's just like he just seems like a goober.
You don't know anything about the guy besides the fact that he made a song and streams.
Sometimes you look at a guy and you're just like, yeah, he kind of looks like a fucking goober. Especially if you feel like you need to wear a fucking formal suit to your stream. That's so kind of gooberish behavior.
The man wants to dress nice for his streams. What's
wrong with that? Him how to dress.
Yeah, but it's a little bit gooberish.
What are you wearing right now, McNasty? I bet you're not wearing a 3-piece
shirt and sweats.
Champion shirt. Yeah, where's your nice suit for your stream?
I have a suit, and I don't show my face when I stream. Why would I wear a suit?
I feel like. Do you own a suit? I feel like you've never worn
a
suit.
No.
That makes sense.
I used to have a blazer, but I was
for what? Oh no, you were like one of those fat guys.
I just never really needed one, so I just...
One of those fat guys.
Dude, that's literally fat guy go-to! Triple XL t-shirt with a fucking blazer.
What the fuck?
No, I had it for, like, if there was some kind of... Like, if I had to fucking go to a wedding or something, I would...
Yeah, like a McDonald's t-shirt with a blazer over top.
No, I wouldn't wear a McDonald's t-shirt. Or wear, like, a dress shirt under it. You fucking ass.
Man, he just came for your ass.
I know. Oh, you're one of those fat lards, huh?
You're one of those worthless pieces of shit.
Bro, I feel like that's the go-to for a fact. It's just a blazer and jeans and like any random cotton t-shirt.
One of my first.
I didn't know there was a fat guy thing. I've seen plenty of skinny people wear that. Well, maybe not Mr. fucking Saint Laurent boy.
You know I was broke for like the first 23 years.
I came back at you, Saint Laurent boy.
Fashion fight, let's go, queens. Fashion fight.
Whose fit is more expensive right now? Go.
Oh, dude, those videos are the fucking worst. And they all look like complete jackasses.
I bought my shorts from Old Navy.
And nothing wrong with that. Especially when you're getting fish guts and dog puke on them all day like you do.
That's right. Amen.
Let's eat.
I told you guys about when I threw up on a dog recently, didn't I?
Yeah, you did.
Okay.
Yeah,
I think about that a lot, so I just wanted to make sure I told you guys.
One of our, Smitty was having a party, it's probably like 4 years ago, and this was when his dog, Octavia, was a puppy still. And there was a party, and they opened the back door to like go smoke or whatever, and they didn't know the dog.
Real quick, what was the dog's name?
Octavia, I don't know. I just call her Yogurt because it reminds me of Activia. So I've called her Yogurt since she was a little pupper. But Octopus. Yeah, they didn't know she got out. And one of her friends was peeing off the deck. We're like, man,
sounds
like quiet. Like you expect it to like, it was like winter too. So you'd expect it to like hit the hard ground and like you'd hear the sound of pee. And you really couldn't hear anything. And then after like 10 seconds, you start to hear it hit the ground. We're like, damn, that was kind of weird. And then Taves comes around the corner and she's just dripping wet.
Why did she stand there and just get peed on?
She was like either digging or something or like was interested in the plant or something.
Dogs are fucking retarded.
Yeah, so. It was a dog. It's not like the dog was like, oh, I'm getting peed on, no way, and like sat there.
I feel like if I was getting my dog wet with something like a hose or something, they'd instantly like want to run away from it.
Some dogs don't care.
Maybe it was just because it was warm. Like,
your dog clearly does not have good instinct. You literally gassed that little fucker on your bed and it didn't move. But
my dog is basically an Auschwitz.
What do you mean by that?
Just getting gassed constantly.
Yeah.
Just you farting on it repeatedly.
Poor little Auschwitz doggy.
Anyways.
Auschwitz dog.
No, he didn't deny it.
I've already explained this situation a bunch of times.
Yeah, well.
True goons viewers.
Tell it to the grudge.
She's like walking down backwards down the stairs. I'm just like telling her, yeah, my dog, I didn't fart on her. She's facing away from me.
That might have been the fucking stupidest thing.
To the grudge.
Oh, man. That one got me. I don't know why that got me as much as it did, but
that was pretty.
That was a good fucking hee-haw right there.
Pretty dumb, but good.
There used to be a show called Hee-Haw.
What do I do with that?
What do I do with that, dude? I usually know how to respond to
you.
I
recommend watching it.
Do you?
Yeah, no, I'll pass.
Do you really? Mm-hmm. Is it that good?
You suggested lizard lick towing, and then after that, I was like, I'm not listening to anything this guy fucking says.
Opinion revolt.
Dude, I'm trying to tell you guys about good media, all right? Lizard lick towing is worth watching.
I'm going to pass on that, to be honest.
Okay.
I care about you as a friend, and your opinions are usually pretty good, but this time I'm just like,
Comment section, let them know about lizard lick towing.
I hope somebody has been impounded by lizard lick towing. It's very heated about that.
Lizard lick towing.
Lizard dick towing.
Lizard anus.
All right, use code GOONS.
Code goons. 10% off and a 10% off.
Buy some G subs.
10% off.
Do it, or you're a coward.
Code goons. There you go.
The burp really, really did not last that whole time.
It didn't, dude. Sometimes you got it, and sometimes you don't. I ain't as good as I want.
Use code goons. For 10% off.
We have one
That's
more topic.
That's a very bad song. That is an awful
That's
song.
That's a really
yeah,
good song.
Should,
fuck you.
We need to end on... We need to end on a better conversation.
Okay, would you rather be known for sucking off Hitler?
No!
Lose your legs.
We did literally... We recorded for 20 seconds. For like 2 hours yesterday, and this was 90% of the session, is would you rathers.
Would
you
rather
there was
is
some
a good...
good ones.
Conversation.
There it's was a, some great ones. I'll give you that. There was some pretty funny ones.
But it was always, would you rather X, Y, and Z or lose your legs?
Or lose your legs. For some reason, Super really, really liked.
Because I feel like legs. That's a pretty detrimental meme.
That is a meme, isn't it?
I don't know if you I'd call that a meme.
All you quadriplegic good people, is this a good meme that you had done to you there?
Yeah, you big old fucking placemats. You big old memes.
Big old placemats.
Human potatoes.
All right.
You're almost a placemat. You just need to add one word to your name.
Placemath.
And take away a T.
Placema?
Yeah, so really not that close.
Would you rather your whole family die or lose both your legs?
Sorry, Mom.
Yeah, bye. Bye, Mom. You already lived half your life. See ya. Keeping my legs. Can I trade it? Can I keep, like, one parent per leg?
No.
I guess I'll become Geodude.
McNasty?
Both.
Both.
Kill legs and parents.
Kill my family and cut off my legs.
I want to be just like the best pity fuck of all time. Like they just cannot say no because my life story is so sad.
Mm-hmm.
I killed my parents. So oh,
take my legs.
I want him. I want
exactly.
him. He's so hot.
He's thinking outside the box.
I didn't mean you killed your parents, but yeah.
McNasty, what was yours? Shitting constantly or pissing constantly?
That was me.
That was Yummy's. Yeah.
Oh.
No.
We were all.
I take credit for that.
Mine was you have to wake up every other day, 800 pounds.
Mine was Joe Biden's little slut puppy.
Yeah.
Got to go to his little meetings with him. You just sit there. He's got you on a collar. Got to take your 16 naps a day with him.
He calls you kitten.
Would you rather drink a gallon of hot candle wax or be lit on fire completely for 30 seconds?
So either do I want to look like a raisin? Or do I want my insides to be jacked the fuck up? I'll sign up for the insides.
Yeah, it's gotta be the insides.
Really?
It's gotta be, yeah.
You think you could shit out all that candle wax? Dude, you
no,
could probably...
No, absolutely not. I'm going to the hospital regardless.
How quick do you die from being set on fire, too? I don't know. 30, that sounds like a long time to be set
okay,
on fire.
Okay. Set on fire completely for 10 seconds.
Okay, you know what? No, I'll still swallow the candle wax.
Yeah.
I wonder how candle wax would react in your body.
Probably not great, because it's candle wax.
Like, do you think your body would process it and, like, poop it out?
What if you just shit out a full candle?
Yeah, you could probably make, like, a little shit candle if you put, like, a little, like, one of those little strings in the end of a turd.
Yeah, no, swallow some dental floss.
You mean a wick?
Halfway a through string. The... No, yeah, just dental floss it. Dental floss and hot wax. You got your own homemade candles.
Mm-hmm.
Take that to the bank. There
I'd
you
rather
go.
Just go to the store and buy a candle for $3.
Okay, well, we're not all wealthy YouTubers, McNasty.
Not everyone can do
Some
that.
Some people have to still shit
there
their candles
are.
Out. It's okay. All right. Some people still have to work for their candles.
Yeah.
I gotta shit them out like regular people.
McNasty's out of touch.
Exactly.
Yeah, I am out of touch.
So do the outro.
Would you rather lay your penis out on a table and get it hit by a hammer, like smash?
Would you rather download on Spotify or download on Apple Podcasts?
Or would you rather use code GOONS or...
Or would you rather let an elephant stick its whole penis in your butt?
Oh, that one.
Who?
That one.
Who's holding the hammer?
Would you rather...
The Rock.
Yeah, The Rock.
Okay, then I'm down. Sign me up for that. That's kind of hot. Little Dwayne action.
It's about dick. It's about dick. It's about dick.
I mean dick. I mean dick.
Fuck, I love dick.
Download on Spotify. Please like and comment on YouTube. Thank you guys for listening. Code Goons, G-Sups.
That was like the most depressing outro we've done.
Please download on Spotify. Please.
Please. Please, mama.
Mama.
Mama, please download it.
Mama, download on Spotify.
I'm in a new podcast. Right. Mama. I'm leaving.
Would you rather use code Goons for G-Subs or lose your family? Choice is yours.
You have 5 hours.
We are inside your home.